As we all know, RMC is the most efficient way of producing concrete. Worldwide, the penetration of RMC in construction is almost 80%, while in India, still we are at the level of 10-15%. While as this is a challenge, but also gives a great opportunity of introducing ready-mix concrete in the construction. As we all know, one of the biggest challenge in the current construction is the speed and the quality of construction. Today, with the infrastructure being a major focus by the government, I think there is a need for improving the speed, but at the same time, build quality structures. While as ready-mix concrete is not a new introduction to India, but I think it calls for an early adoption by the construction industry. Specifically, with respect to the infrastructure and large urban development, RMC has to be the way forward if we are to really achieve the dream of 25 trillion economy. We know today one of the major cost escalation is due to the project delays, and there are various reasons for the project delays. And if we are able to use ready-mix concrete in speeding up the processes and the construction speed, I'm sure this will not only save a lot of time, but as well as achieve economies of scale. We all know today how difficult to produce wave batch concrete on site. There are challenges with respect to quality of the raw material, availability of natural sand, availability of good quality aggregate at the various locations is becoming a big challenge. But all these problems can be solved by ready-mix concrete. Ready-mix concrete gives a very flexibility of mix design, optimizing the raw material, as well as ensuring that we produce the designed concrete depending upon the end use and application, right from M20 grade of concrete to M80 grade of concrete required for various infrastructure. This flexibility is rather impossible if you adopt for a site mix concrete. With the advent of admixtures, there is a huge amount of development that has happened by use of admixtures in ready mix to further enhance the properties of concrete. For example, with respect to durability, with respect to making it resistance to chemical attacks, with respect to improving the density of the concrete, thus making it almost impermeable, and so on and so forth. So I think ready-mix concrete is a very fast developing field in the material side of the construction industry. And at this point of time, huge amount of development is happening on producing good quality concrete. The second very important advantage of concrete is the consistency batch after batch, which is a big challenge when it comes to site construction. Hence, adopting to ready-mix to ensure consistency quality in construction is a greatest advantage that can be offered. Similarly, the entire quality control process, right from selection of the raw material till the end concrete strength results or the parameter results, can be monitored in a very robust way. Today, the technology has become so advanced that even there are maturity meters which are installed in the concrete elements to measure the real-time strength development in the concrete. And hence, there are great amount of technological development in promoting good quality of concrete. Earlier adoption of this will not only improve the quality of concrete, but also reduce the cost. The recent announcement of National Infrastructure Pipeline of almost 2.5 trillion to be spent on infrastructure by government before 2025 calls for huge amount of spend on the infrastructure. That can be only possible through a rapid adoption of ready-mix concrete across. Even, for example, coming to the residential sector, we find that the absorption or the adoption of ready-mix concrete is relatively slower, specifically in B and C category towns. Still, site mix is very, very prevalent, and hence we end up with not only poor quality of concrete, but also abnormal delay in construction. And hence, ready mix concrete offers an excellent solution for these challenges, even in B and C category towns. And hence, collectively, as an industry and the government, they need to promote very aggressively the adoption of ready mix concrete in construction, specifically with respect to revisiting the GST, which is currently at 18%, can we look at making at par with steel at 4% since being a value-added product? At the same time, there are a lot of hurdles with respect to getting the raw materials, good quality raw materials across the various locations. And hence, there should be a specific policy addressing the concerns of ready-mix concrete producers in providing good quality raw material on a sustainable basis so that the earlier adoption of RMC happens in most of the cities. RMC is one of the biggest contributor to sustainability. As you all know, highest consumption of fly ash and GGBS happens in ready mix concrete due to highly controlled conditions of producing concrete, which is almost impossible in case of site mix. And hence, even it is adding to the reduction of clinker or the cement, which is one of the greatest contributor to greenhouse gas effects. And hence, indirectly, ready mix is more sustainable even as compared to cement in the site mix is concerned. And hence, making available the blending cementitious material like fly ash and GGBS at a very reasonable cost and consistent quality and availability needs to be also looked into. A third very important aspect is that we all know that ready-mix concrete has a very, very small shelf life of maybe less than 3 hours. And hence the challenges of prioritizing the movement of ready-mix transit mixers in a city has to be looked into along with the related pumps and the labors that move along. This can enable the 24 hours working of the ready-mix concrete in almost every cities without losing the time so that the speed of construction can be enhanced without disturbing the overall construction activity. If we allow the site mix in most of the places in the infrastructure, there are challenges of space in the site, there are challenges of pollution. As we all know, in case of NCR, every year how it is difficult to pass through the winter with a very high pollution level and the construction needs to be banned. But instead, we can use the route of ready-mix concrete, which is highly controlled production facility with following all the pollution control norms, and but still the construction go on. For example, very important infrastructure like metro, RRTS, which are coming up in Delhi NCR, can continue to work throughout the year 24/7, and these are the infrastructure who actually decongest the city going forward and reduce the pollution over a period of time. And hence, there is an urgent need to look into how we can enable RMC by the policy makers, which will add on to speed, faster construction, as well as quality infrastructure construction, which is almost maintenance free. As we all know that in the direction of producing world-class infrastructure, I feel there is no alternative but to use ready-mix concrete in the construction. Apart from this, this also provides huge amount of employment. For example, the entire manpower involved in the raw material movement, production, as well as the transit mixers and the pumps, and hence it generates good quality employment across the various cities for the local skilled or even semi-skilled labor. And hence, RMC not only just as a value-added product in the construction, but also generates employment across the cities. Today, we all know it is almost impossible to imagine some of the mega structures, for example, the high-speed rail link between Mumbai and Ahmedabad is almost impossible if we imagine to be built on a site mix concrete. And hence, ready mix is the way forward as far as concrete and the construction is concerned. And it calls for everyone's support, everyone's view of looking RMC as a value added way of producing concrete in the long term.